Hello everyone, welcome back to Force Galaxy. Hope you all are good. So in today's video we're going to discuss one of the automation process we are having in Salesforce, that is workflow rules. So we'll discuss everything, how to create workflow rules, what are workflow rules, what different actions we can perform using them, and in what scenarios we should go with our workflow rules, its limitation, its limit, everything. So let's start with our video. So now let's start with the scenario. Whenever my opportunity is closed one, I want some email to be sent to the opportunity owner automatically. Similarly, whenever my opportunity is closed lost, I want some field to be updated automatically. For both the above scenario, as you can see, whenever my criteria is met, I want some actions to be automated. So to perform all these type of automation process, Salesforce provide different or multiple automation tools to automate our business or organization process. And one of the automation tool is workflow rules, which we're going to discuss today in our video. Now come to the definitions. Workflow in Salesforce. Workflow in Salesforce is basically a container or a business logic engine which automates certain criteria or certain actions based on particular criteria. If the criteria or the conditions are met, then the actions will be executed, as if the criteria are not met, then the record will get saved and no actions will be executed. So basically workflow rule is divided into the two main components. One is criteria and the second is action. Criteria which make the workflow rule to run, and the action, what different action we want to perform when my criteria is met. So consider an example, that is whenever my opportunity is closed one, I want an email to be sent to the opportunity owner. So in this scenario, stage equals to close one is my criteria, and sending an email to the owner is my action which I want to perform whenever my condition is met. So whenever my condition is met, then the action sending an email alert will going to execute, else it will simply going to save my record and no action will get executed. Now let's discuss what different type of actions we can perform using workflow rules. So number one is immediate actions. These are the actions which are executed immediately whenever my record is created or edited. In immediate actions, we have four different type of actions which we can perform. One is creating a task, second is sending an mail, third is updating a field, and the fourth is sending an outbound messages. Now the second we have time dependent actions. These are the actions which are executed after a certain period of time. Example, if I want to send an email before my opportunity is close date, before the 10 days of my opportunity close date. So these are the actions which are executed in future. Also now come to the different evaluation criteria we are having in our workflow rule. So number one is created. This is simple, whenever my record is created. Number two is created and edited, whenever my record is updated. Number three is created and every time edited subsequently meet the criteria. So this is the most important criteria need to understand, and we're going to discuss this on our screen where you will be more clear what's the difference between two, second and the third. So now let's move to our screen and discuss more about the workflow rules.
So here I have created a workflow on opportunity object with name opportunity workflow. And now here you can see I have three evaluation criteria. One is created, the rule will never run more than once per a record. Now the second is created and every time edited. With this option, the rule repeatedly runs every time a record is edited as long as the record meets the rule criteria. Now we have our third evaluation, created and anytime it's edited to subsequently meet the criteria. Now for a new record, the rule, it will run the rule if the rule criteria is met. Now if the record is updated, then it will run the rule only if the rule record is changed from not meeting the rule criteria to meeting the rule criteria. Example, if I have a criteria of checkbox is equals to true. Now if I have my updated my record and the checkbox value is false, and now I have provided the new value as true, now it will run the workflow, but it will not run the workflow in the case when my criteria value is already true, and again I have edit it and the record value is again true. So now here I have an option to add the rule criteria, and yes, we will add the criteria. I have a checkbox filled on my opportunity, so I will add the criteria whenever this checkbox is true. So now I am done with the rule criteria. Now it's time to add the action. I have two action, immediate and the time based. So now for now I will add the immediate action, and in this I have four options: task, email, alert, now field update and outbound messages. So I will select the email field update. So here we need to provide the name of our action. Below I have the fields of opportunity. We can select the field which we want to update. So here, as you can see, here is a checkbox of reevaluate workflow rules. So when this checkbox is set to true, if the field update changes the field value, all the workflow rules on the associated object are re-evaluated. So if the if any criteria for any workflow is met, then it will run the that particular workflow again. So here we'll provide some string value so to update the description field. So here I'm done with criteria also and with the actions which to perform. Now done, and time to activate the workflow. So here I'm on my opportunity object. So this is my checkbox. And my description is empty, so let's make it true. Now save. So workflow rule is fired. Now my description field is updated. Now let's remove this value and again edit the record. Let's just save it. So now here your record is again edited, but the value in active checkbox is true to true only. Right now in this case workflow rule will not fire. Now if again I make it from false to true, I make it true, so now it will run the workflow. That is, it will check that particular value for your criteria and check if it is from not meet to criteria, meet the criteria, then only it will going to run the workflow.
So now it is clear what we can do using the workflow rules. Number one is we can create a task for someone. Number two is we can send an automated email. Number three is we can send an outbound messages to the external platform. And number fourth is we can update our database by updating the field, by updating any field. Now some points to remember. Number one is by default workflow rules are limited up to the 50 active workflow per object. Number two is by using the action of updating a field, we can either update its parent field or its own record field only. That is, we cannot update its child object fields. Number three is we cannot delete any workflow rules if its actions are in the workflow queue. So either we have to wait for the actions to be processed or we need to cancel them from the workflow queue. Hope you guys enjoy the video, and in our next video we're going to discuss about the time-based workflow rules and look what different the amazing points we are having regarding the time-based workflow rules. So Thanks for watching, and those who didn't subscribe, do subscribe and share with your friends if you like the content. Thank you.